Zephaniah, Minor Prophet. Zephaniah's ministry probably took place around the time of Assyria's fall in 612 BC. Zephaniah warned the people of Judah that if they refused to repent, the entire nation, including the beloved city of Jerusalem, would be lost. The people knew that God would eventually bless them, but Zephaniah made it clear that there would be judgment first, then blessing. This judgment would not be merely punishment for sin, but it would also be a means of purifying the people. Though we live in a fallen world surrounded by evil, we can hope in the perfect kingdom of God to come, and we can allow any punishment that touches us now to purify us from sin. Climate of the times. Zephaniah prophesied in the days of Josiah, king of Judah. Josiah followed God, and during his reign, the book of the law was discovered in the temple. He was the last good king in Judah. After reading the book of law, Josiah began a great religious revival in Judah. We can read it in 2 Kings chapter 22 and 23. Zephaniah helped fan the revival by warning the people that judgment would come if they did not return from their sins. Although this great revival turned the nation back to God, it did not fully eliminate idolatry and lasted only a short time. Just 4 years after Josiah's death, Nebuchadnezzar swept into Palestine and took the first wave of Israelite captives into exile. The people of Judah were clearly warned by the highest authority of all, God. They refused to listen, either because they doubted God's prophet and thus did not believe that the message was from God, or because they doubted God himself and thus did not believe that he would do what he said. If we refuse to listen to God's word, the Bible, we are as short-sighted as the people of Judah, and like them, we will be also punished. We may wonder how the Israelites could have heard such clear warnings and still not turn to God. The problem was that they had allowed sin to so harden them that they no longer cared to follow God. They refused to heed God's warnings and they refused to repent. The more God punished them, the more they sinned. If you are living in disobedience to God now, your heart may grow hard and you may lose all desire for God. God will remove the proud people and leave the lowly and humble. God is opposed to the proud and arrogant of every generation. But those who are lowly and humble, both physically and spiritually, will be rewarded because they trust in God. Self-reliance and arrogance have no place among God's people or in His kingdom. The message of doom in the beginning of the book of Zephaniah becomes a message of hope by the end. There will be a new day when God will bless His people. If the leaders in the church today were to hear a message from a prophet of God, the message would probably resemble the book of Zephaniah. Under Josiah's religious reforms, the people did return to God outwardly, but their hearts were far from Him. Zephaniah encouraged the nation to gather together and pray for salvation. We must also ask ourselves, is a reform merely an outward show, or is it changing our hearts and lives? We need to gather together and pray, to walk humbly with God, to do what is right, and to hear the message of hope regarding the new world to come. God bless you.